Hi students, welcome to online class. So in this video we are going to discuss about chapter 9, introduction to C++. So in this video now we are going to discuss about the topic memory allocation for character and then float and then double data types. So in already we discussed about the memory allocation for fundamental data types. Character occupies 1 byte, integer occupies 2 bytes, float occupies 4 bytes, then double occupies 8 bytes. So here in this video we are going to see the modifiers is combined with the fundamental data type. The modifiers are going to be combined with the fundamental data type. So how it is differed, how the memory space is differed, and then how the range of values is also differed. So that is what we are going to see here. Can you understand, students? Already we discussed the memory allocation for each and every fundamental data type, and then we discussed about the modifiers. There are 4 modifiers are there: signed, unsigned, long, short. So now in this video we are going to combine the modifier with the fundamental data type. We are going to combine the modifier with the fundamental data type. So when we combine the modifier and the fundamental data type, how the memory space is allocated, and then what are the changes in the range of values, we are going to see here now. So first let us see the character data type. We know very well about character. It occupies 1 byte. It occupies 1 byte, that is 8 bits. So signed ASCII character 1 byte 8 bits, range is -128 to +127. Character occupies, so 1 byte, that is 8 bits, -128 to +127. When we go for unsigned character means the ASCII character should not contain any sign. Unsigned means only positive. So ASCII characters without sign, 1 byte 8 bits, but the range is different. See here, 0 to 255, because no negative values are involved, only positive. So 0 to 255, right? When we go for signed character, so it allows with the sign, so the range is -128 to +127, -128 to +127. So it occupies the same 1 byte 8 bits, 1 byte 8 bits. Now we are going to see the memory allocation for floating data types. So we know already float data type, it occupies 4 bytes, 32 bits, 4 bytes, 32 bits, that is 3.4 into 10 power minus 38 to 3.4 into 10 power 38 power minus 1. So that is what we discussed in the previous videos. So here also the same, but when it is gone for double and long double, see here, double means it occupies 8 bytes, 64 bits. It occupies 8 bytes, that is 64 bits. So what is the range? So here signed more precision fractional value. Double means the double the float. We can have more precision values, that is after the decimal point we can have more number of values. After the decimal point we can have more number of values. Then see the long double. When double is combined with long, then what will happen? So double occupies 8 bytes already, then again it is combined with long, so 8 plus 2 10 bytes. So 10 bytes means 80 bits. 10 bytes means 80 bits. So that is they have given, see here, long double signed more precision fractional value, that is 10 bytes 80 bits. Can you understand, students? Just we want to see the how much memory is allocated in terms of bytes and bits. How much memory is allocated in terms of bytes and bits? We want to remember the range also. So this is how the memory is allocated for the floating data types, that is float, double, long double, and then for character data type, that is signed character, unsigned character, character. See, memory allocation is subjected to vary based on the type of the compiler that is being used. See, whenever we use Turbo C++ compiler, the memory is different when we use with Dev C++ compiler. See, there are different types of compilers are there, students. So you know already in the previous videos we have discussed Turbo C++, Dev C++. So like that we discussed many compilers. Each and every compiler, it allocates the memory in a different manner. When we go for Turbo C++ compiler, it is somehow different when we compare with the Dev C++ compiler. Dev C++ compiler provides some more space to int and long, int, long and double data types. Dev is only allocating much amount of memory space for the integer, long and double. When you see the table, then you can understand the memory allocation, that is the difference, different compilers, how it is allocating the memory space for the data types. We can see the difference between Turbo C++ and Dev C++ compilers memory allocation in a table, in a tabular form. You can see here. So Turbo C++, when we go with the short means short int, so that occupies 2 bytes, they have also 2 bytes. Then unsigned short, signed short, in signed short you see here, so 2 bytes. Now you see the integer data type, ordinarily integer data type it occupies 2 bytes in Turbo C++, but when we go for Dev C++ it occupies 4 bytes. So that is the difference. In Turbo C++, integer occupies only 2 bytes, whereas in Dev C++ it occupies 4 bytes of memory. And then see the long also the same 4 bytes. But when you see the other things, all of them most commonly they are same. Unsigned long, signed long, all are same. Character, unsigned character, signed character, 1 byte. So each and every compiler occupies only 1 byte. Character means 1 byte. Integer means the Turbo it occupies 2, Dev C++ it occupies 4. Then float Turbo C++ occupies 4, Dev C++ also occupies 4. Double means 88 bytes. Double means 88 bytes. So long double means Turbo C++ it occupies 10. Why it occupies 10? Because double it gives you 8. So long double means 8 plus 2, 10. So that is the concept. But here double it occupies 8 for Dev, then 8 plus 4 it occupies 12. So Dev C++ provides 4 bytes to int and long. Int and long it occupies same amount of bytes, 4 bytes. Any one of these bytes can be used to handle bigger integer values. So whatever the data type you want, you can use. Either you can use int or float, because both of them occupies 4 bytes of memory. Both of them occupies 4 bytes of memory. Like that, when you go for size of operator, what is mean by size of operator? Size of operator which gives the size of a data type. Size of operator which is used to give the size of the data type. How much size is allocated for a particular variable. So that is specified by the size of data type. So size of data type we can discuss in the later examples. So size of is an operator which is used to give the size. How much size is allocated, how much memory size is allocated for the particular variable. Right, it is an important operator. Then we want to discuss about number suffixes in C++. Number suffixes in C++. What is mean by number suffixes? See, after the number, you can suffix a character. After the number, that is after the integer value or after the floating point value, we can add a suffix. We can add a suffix. See here, number suffixes in C++. There are different suffixes for integer and floating point numbers. Suffix can be used to assign the same value as a different type. Suffix means what they are saying? It is used to assign the same value as a different type. For example, you are assigning an integer value. So instead of assigning the integer value, you can add some suffix and then you can change into some other value and then you can assign. For example, 3.14 is a floating point value. Instead of assigning floating point value, you can change it to some other thing, maybe integer or long, right? So like that you can assign. See here, they have given some examples. For example, if you want to store 45 in int, long, unsigned int and unsigned long int, you can use suffix. You can use the suffix letter L or U. See, if I want to store 45 as a long, then how can I store 45 L? Instead of giving 45, if I give 45 L, then what will happen? The value 45 will be stored as a long value. That is long int. Instead of that, if I want to store it as unsigned int, I can use 45 U. So 45 U stands for unsigned int. So that is what here they are saying. Whatever the value you are assigning to a variable, instead of assigning the value to the variable, you can convert it into some other data type. You can convert it into some other data type by giving the suffix letter. For example, 45 L stands for 45 long. The value 45 belongs to long. If I give 45 U, the value 45 is assigned as a unsigned integer. To the variable. Can you understand, students? This is about suffix. Like that, see here, this type of declaration instructs the compiler. This type of declaration instructs the compiler to store the given value as long and unsigned. So the value will be stored as a long value or unsigned value. Instead of storing 45, you can store it as 45L or 45U. So what will happen? The value 45 will be stored as a long value. Then the value 45 will be stored as an unsigned value. So like that, here you see F can be used for floating point value. So instead of 3.14, if I assign 3.14 F, the value will be assigned as a floating point value. Can you understand, students? So I think you might have understood this video regarding the memory allocation for floating point data types. And then character data types, number suffixes. So let's end the class. So thank you, students.